We're doing 90 miles a day round trip. We're doing 3 passes today: Hancock Pass, Napolean Pass, and Tin Cup Pass, all over 12,000 feet elevation. We just came down Hancock Pass and stopped at the town of Pitkin to refuel. We ate some lunch, got hydrated, and started heading up our second pass for the day, Napolean Pass.
We just left that town a little while back, heading up this road. Starting to climb an elevation. In our hooves. We just topped off the main road onto this four-wheel drive here. A little rocking. Woo. A little windy, had to run back to the vehicle. We were hanging out, getting ready to come up on this trail, and fuel pump went out on Dave and Steve's Jeep in the rear back there, so all of us are watching him change that, joking, messing around. Now it's like 2 p.m. right now, and we're getting started on the second part. Let's put it low. Now we're cooking with oil. Thin air up here. Somebody stuck back there?
Copy that, we'll come pull you off.
Oh. Someone stuck?
Yeah. He has a winch.
Oh, he has a winch, huh?
Yeah.
We'll get up the hill a little bit where it's flat. Wait a minute for everybody to catch up.
Oh, okay. So I need to go forward. Somebody got stuck.
You gotta break it in.
There you go. The boys and the goat pulled him up with the toe strap. Need a little bump. A little bumpity bump. Good job, boys.
Pulling him?
No, they just
released him?
Yeah, just a little bump with it out through. Every once in a while, everybody gets one.
I ain't afraid of no winch.
Remember that? I ain't afraid of no winch. Oh, Brandon, man, his winch was running like 300 miles an hour, winching us all up that rock in Moab. sun came up and got hot. I gotta open some of these here. There we go, like that. Yep, we're still going up, gaining some altitude. Into the pines now. Put her to sleep again. Stop right now. We were behind this little mountain here, came up above the trees, and then Ron took us down for a little extra guided tour here to this mine that he doesn't regularly do, but since we got a little group, let's make a little pit stop here for a little bit. Spectacular view. Let's go check out that mine. Thanks, Ron, for showing us one of your little secret spots over here. Now we're going to get back on the main trail and get on up to the peak. Rocking and rolling.
It's rocking and rolling.
off camber, both sides. First to the left, and then to the right, and then to the left again. All right, beautiful. We are above the tree line again. 12,000 feet. Yep, switched it out to EFI Sniper Sniper 2 on there. Yeah, all of us are not happy with the altitude. He's got his hood open, vapor locked. I think this one's vapor locked. EFI is not supposed to vapor lock, but here we are. Old goat's running good. We're just gonna wait this out for a little bit. All right. He's a pumping, got the hood up.
Hey, you're not on the trail.
I am on the trail.
You're not. It's over there.
Where?
The trail's right there.
So I waited about 10 minutes and it fired up. Just got it in first gear right now. I got the hood up.
Watch out, it's a drop.
Steve and Dave back there, they got their hood up too. Thin air up there, thin air. But we shouldn't be having these problems with the EFI. It must be me. I'm the installer, so.
Pause real quick.
I got full view over here. Wife's all worried I can't see because the hood is up. Because that's what she sees. But this is what we're seeing. We're good. We need to get it up there to the plateau where Ron and those guys are at. Give her a little rest and she'll be fine. Yeah, she's all right. I think I need to do some re-engineering of that fuel lines. The problem is there's no space down there. All the real estate is occupied. On EFI. Damn.
Vapor locked in, bro?
Vapor locked, yeah. Crazy, huh? Hey, him too.
Well, we stopped at the bottom of the hill when he was having trouble. And it heat soaked and he vapor locked at the bottom now. We opened the hood and waited, and then we were able to go up the big hill with the hood up.
Yeah.
So I'm not shutting it off again. It didn't vapor lock once yesterday.
Well, this is probably going to be the most significant climb you're going to have.
That's okay. Yeah.
The rest of them are, well, we're going to be going downhill, so you shouldn't have a problem.
Okay, right on. Shouldn't be having a problem with EFI, though. But I think I need to re-engineer the fuel lines.
Are they right next to the exhaust or what?
Well, yeah, it's about a good 4 inches from way back there. So, we'll figure it out.
Or put some of that up.
Yeah, the wrap. Yeah. I should have put wrap on there, huh? Yeah. All right, well. We made it.
Well, you made it.
All right, we're on the downhill now.
That was an adventure.
Adventure. All right. because my engine wasn't hot. It was like at 180. But I guess the exhaust is just enough to get that fuel hot. And of course, there's no air up here. Nothing grows above 12,005. And we are up here. Well, that's no excuse. This thing should be quitting on me like that. I need to be re-engineer those fuel lines. Or I need to go to O'Reilly's and buy me some wrap. Wrap those things up good until I get home. Anyhow, we're back at it. Back on the rocks. There's air up here and we'll be happier. I'm running right over his little house right now. Yeah, we got some grass growing now. Huffing and puffing. That was Napolean Pass on the way down. Camber too. There we go. Nice lie. Good job, Ernie. Well, thank you, Ernie. big one right there. See if you get some scratches. Yeah. Slipping and sliding. Side. Tight maneuvering through those woods right now. There's some more right here. To the right. A little pinstripe into the right. Big ditch to the left.
That's my door.
Right there.
That's the right.
Yeah.
Right there.
was cool. Hit your arm on that thing?
Every time?
We gotta modify the seat. These things gotta come off.
Yeah,
not now. It was when we hit the rock crawling. They're bumping her elbows. I got a cure for that. Hacksaw Jackson. Driving the CFI for like, I don't know, a good 5 weeks. All over town, up and down hills. No issue. I get up to 12.5. 12,500 feet, and then maybe the computer stopped working or something at 12.5. I need to put an airplane computer on here for 12.5. Down here to the mine. That's what Ron was just saying. Make our last break over here before we start heading up Tin Cup Pass. But Tin Cup Pass is gonna be the part 3 of this video. I think we're gonna end it here. We're still rolling. The sun's about to go down behind that mountain. Looks like it's gonna be a night ride. Tin Cup Pass. Thanks for watching. Catch you in the next one.